webinar on hybrid energy storage for electric vehicle. She is from Marwari University, located in Rajkot, Gujarat, and she has completed in a PhD in physics, and she has completed BSc MSc in physics, and she has completed in Bachelor of Education also. And his area of interest is supercapacitor, activated carbon, and polymer electrolytes. She is having teaching experience about 9 years, and she has been working in colleges like Government PG College, Satna, and JP University of Engineering and Technology, that is located in Madhya Pradesh. And currently, she is working as assistant professor in Department of Physics in Marwari University. And she has done a remarkable work in research. That is, she is having research publication about 7 international journals, all are Scopus indexed to 1. And 5 papers is under process. She has communicated his research article to the 5. He has communicated 5 research papers still under progress. So she has published a paper in international conference about 13, and she has participated in workshop about 21. And the most significant achievement and award she has received is best oral presentation. She has received that award from Sharda University, that is in the year 2020, for attending the conference and delivering the lecture on electrolyte. And you can see in the slide, so what the list of papers published per in international journals, that is in the year 2021. She has published a paper describing about a polymer gel as an effective electrolyte. And in 2020, she has published a paper related to supercapacitor and polyvinyl dichloride. And she has done comparative studies on ionic liquid and polymer gel electrolyte. The other papers in 2018, she has published related to zinc oxide nanofiller based composite polymer. Then in the year 2017, she has done a paper in electrical studies on ionic liquid based polymer gel electrolyte. And the current research, she is doing current research in these areas. In that, we are going to see this hybrid energy storage device in operation of electric vehicle that will be related to mechanical, automobile, and electrical engineers. So she has done a research in hybrid energy storage, and the research is under progress, and she has submitted his research finding to the international journals. So on behalf of Shastha Institute of Engineering and Technology and Department of Mechanical and Automobile Engineering, welcomes Dr. Mukhtar Tirupathi for the webinar.
So thank you so much, Professor Subramaniam, for inviting me for this particular webinar.
Yes.
I am really happy and grateful for your invitation. It's a very good opportunity to me. So thank you so much. Thank you so much for all departments of Sri Shastha institutions. Really, your profile is very good, and all the things in your institution is looks very nice. Thank you so much for providing. Hope all the other things what we have to do before the webinar has been completed yet. So can we start?
Yes, madam. We are requesting you to upload your PPT and you can start your presentation, madam.
Thank you so much. I'm sharing my screen here.
Yes, madam.
I request, hope my voice is clear to all participants. If it is not, you are requested, please let me know.
My voice is audible, madam.
Thank you so much. So I'm going to share my screen here. If it is visible to you, you are requested, please confirm it. Yes, my screen is visible to you.
Yes, madam, it is visible.
Thank you so much. So let's start this webinar. Really, the thing, the doing this webinar is very good. And the topic we have chosen here, the hybrid energy storage device for electrical vehicle. So I would like to thank Professor Subramaniam and his team. So let's start. This is the outline of the presentation. You can see here, these are where I have organized this particular presentation very, very, very short way, because this is the broad field, and if we are going to discuss, there is no any limit. So look at this. These are the points we have to discuss. The introduction of the energy storage device. Because all of you are a little bit familiar about the energy storage, we have to know why exactly, what is exactly the energy storage device, and what are the part of energy storage devices, how we will synthesize the electrode material as well as the electrolyte material. So part of this introduction, we'll discuss types of the energy storage device, fabrication of the energy storage devices like a supercapacitors, because I'm working in supercapacitor. So I will cover the large area related to the supercapacitor as well as the hybrid device. So hybrid device, energy storage device, we'll discuss why there is a need to modify the energy storage device in hybrid form. So that we will discuss, and various applications. So let's start this. Nowadays, you know very well, the energy is very much consumed by the peoples, and there are a lot of ways that we can store our energy. So peoples are trying their best for storing the energy. Sometimes people are trying to use some solar panels for this is the source of the solar energy, has been converted in the electrical energy, wind energy, and the hydrothermal energy. A lot of resources are available in the market now. The battery and the supercapacitor are used in so many devices like these. You can see the portable device, we are using the mobile, cell phone, and a lot of things we are using. So battery and the supercapacitor have a major role in these particular devices. Okay, so now the electrical vehicle nowadays is very much required for our society as well as for safe environment. We have to develop this electrical vehicle. So in the terms of that electrical vehicle, the energy storage device, or we can say simply the energy storage device, has been described in three parts. So first is, you can see here the mechanical, and there is a one example I have given, that is the flywheel. Another is the electrochemical. Energy storage devices, a part of that we can consider the battery is working in the electrochemical way. So that's why this is the second type of the energy storage device. The third is the electrostatic, that is the supercapacitor is working on the electrostatic term. So the energy storage for the electrical is the major part we have to discuss today. And this is the key role in the electrical vehicle. Why? Because an energy source is the heart of electrical vehicle. And the two factors that has been characterized in application of electrical energy storage system, that is what? That is the amount of energy that can be stored in the device, and the rate of the energy can be extracted. So for this purpose, presently storage units are available either having high energy density or high power density, but not both. Our effort is what? What is our target that we have to make, and we have to fabricate one device having high energy as well as higher power density. So vehicle imposes the variant deriving and the conditions. So a lot of the factors you can see here we have to need. Let's see what exactly the battery is and the capacitor. Supercapacitor is also known as the ultra capacitors. The main factor you can see by using this particular diagram show you the energy density and the power density factors has been differentiated between two type of the storage devices. So specific energy in the battery, the total amount of energy in the storage device has been cold, and the battery have a higher specific energy, can be run much longer. However, the capacitor, or we can say the ultra capacitor, super capacitor, have the speed which the power can be discharged. So here the discharge capacity has been obtained due to that particular supercapacitor. So high power density, meaning they can provide the high current at a particular time, a shortage of time. Okay, so let's see the more factors related to the battery. The total energy stored in the kilowatt and the weight of the battery unit is considered to improve that technological aspect. Another important factor is what? That is the cost. You can see here the cost of the battery. The total energy can be stored in the battery usually follows the weight and volume and the less linearly. Highest power battery can be delivered also limit. So these are the factors. There are various types of the battery available in the market. That is lead acid battery, nickel cadmium batteries, nickel metal hydride batteries, and nickel zinc batteries. Nowadays there is a good trend of the lithium ion batteries. People are doing their work. A lot of work has been published in the various journals related to the lithium ion battery. So we have to think about the lithium ion battery as well as the supercapacitor. So supercapacitor, also known as the electrical double layer capacitors, also known as the pseudo capacitors, ultra capacitors, have thousands of the farad capacitance we have to find, and relative high specific power density comparison to the battery is much lighter. And so what exactly the role of the supercapacitor in the electrical vehicle? Look at this particular graph here. This is the power density versus your energy graph. So here lot of the portion has been covered due to the supercapacitors. Basically the supercapacitor provides it is used in the electrical vehicle to allow the higher acceleration and the deceleration of the vehicle in a minimum loss of the energy and the conservation of the main battery bank. So here these are the various advantages of the supercapacitors. It provides 22 to 1000 times larger capacitance value compared to the conventional electrolytic capacitor, as well as it is the intermediate power source between the rechargeable battery as well as the conventional electrolytic capacitor. It have a higher specific power density compared to the battery, and our life cycle is better than very very high compared to the battery, as well as the specific energy is greater than the conventional capacitor. So these are the various points. Okay, so main thing is that what exactly the types of the supercapacitor and how we get the good capacitance in the supercapacitor. So there is a lot of types of supercapacitor because of the electrode material. In the market nowadays there is a good trend of the activated carbon. Okay, so first thing is that if you have an activated carbon material, you have to get good capacitance, cheaper device. Okay, so you will get that particular rate, and it is very very good for and safe for environment also. So this is the activated carbon material for the electrode fabrication. So you can see how the carbon material or carbon powder has been synthesized. We'll discuss in next point. So here a carbon have a porous structure, so due to that particular porous structure we get the good capacitance. So here the how many pore sizes there is availability, sometimes we are getting approximately 20 angstrom wide and mesoporous, microporous, and this is the range has been shown here. Pore size is a very important factor in the activated carbon, and it is very important for the electrolyte contact. So here I am showing you how you can activate the carbon material from the raw material available in your society. You can utilize your raw materials, such as here I have one of my paper has been communicated for P based activated carbon. So for this purpose this is the mechanism, this is the process of the synthesis of the activated carbon material. For this purpose, what we have to do, we just take some raw material like this, and this is the bio-based material, and we can just dry it keeping sunlight. Within maybe 2 weeks, you get the proper material for the crushing the powder. You will get the powder form of that particular raw material. You will get the carbonization, and you get the after carbonization, you will get the simple carbon powder. After doing some chemical process, having by setting the temperature 600 to 1000 and all, you will get the activation, and after activation process, this is the form of your particular carbon material. You can wash it properly by the double distilled water, and then after you have to keep it in vacuum oven, and you have to dry properly this carbon material, and you will get finally this powder form. You have to paste this particular carbon in the particular substrate. Like sometimes people are using platinum foil, few people are using graphite sheet, few people are using carbon cloth. So based on what is exactly your requirement, you can paste it. And now this particular carbon material has been utilized for the supercapacitor cell as an electrode material. Because of the good porous structure of this particular carbon material, there is a possibility to get higher capacitance. So these are the various types of the carbon material available in the various type of the minerals, which is selected here: coconut shell based, having good surface area, hardwood, petroleum, coal, peach. So you can utilize any type of the raw material and utilize it in the form of activated carbon. Another thing is that you can also use the electrode material as a carbon nanotube. So high density tube, these are the specifications. Generally, you can utilize this type of the carbon nanotube, and you will get by this particular size has been shown here. Tube size density has been shown here. Tube length 10 to 100 to 300 micrometer. If you have this type of length, you will get that particular energy density as well as the power density. Also, the cycle is 300,000 cycles. So another type material of, you can also utilize the graphene and aerosols, so many things. Now the next point is electrolyte. Because supercapacitor has been formed by sandwiching two type of the electrode material with a particular electrolyte. So for ultra capacitor, there are various types of the electrolytes: liquid electrolytes, solid state electrolyte, and redox additive electrolytes. So here, liquid electrolyte have a two part, that is the acid base alkyne and the KCl. An organized base, you can use the organic salt, then like a TeBr4. Lot of paper I have published in this particular TeBr4. Now the work is going on this particular acid and KOH based work. And here also did my work in anionic liquid, a various type of the mixture has been neutralized on it. These are the various type of the solid state electrolyte, like dry solid polymer. In this, we have to utilize a particular polymer as well as the salt. Here you look at this. So in the case of the redox additive electrolyte for the redox reaction, we can use the redox additive like a Ki and all. So these are the very short description related to the electrolyte, how we can prepare our electrolyte as well as the electrode. Generally, in my work, I have used a solution cast technique. In this particular technique, we can just add several amount of the polymer as well as the your salt as well as the various type of the solvent. We mixed it properly with a particular temperature and given hours, and we get the solution. After that, we will cast it in the petri dish. We'll get the particular gel type of the electrolyte system. Here, this is the process related to the activated carbon. So how we can prepare the electrode material for this purpose? We have taken that PVDF as a particular binder having very less compared to that activated carbon. You can just mix it properly, and for 60 degrees Celsius for 2 hours, you will get the slurry. After that particular slurry, you have to paste this, and you will have to keep it in vacuum oven. You will get the fine film of the electrode. So look at this particular portion is your porous separator. However, this is the double layer capacitor. So this is the very basic mechanism related to the double layer capacitor. Supercapacitor is also known as the electrochemical double layer capacitor, double layer capacitor, supercapacitor, gold capacitor, and so on. Lot of things are available. So these are the basic formula you can use for the capacitors. Okay. This is the very maybe large classification of the ultra capacitor. You can see here the double layer capacitor, hybrid capacitor, as well as the your pseudo capacitor. So double layer capacitor has been formed by various type of the electrode. You can utilize double layer capacitor for the activated carbon nanotube, graphene. Hybrid capacitor has been fabricated by using the hybrid composites, asymmetric battery type hybrid, and the pseudo capacitor has a conducting and the metal oxide. So this is the classification based on there is various model, equivalent circuit, artificial network, and the electrochemical model. Okay, so now you can see, you can balance your cell while you are fabricating your cell. You can just connect it in series to desire the voltage. This is the laboratory setup where you can use various type of the device for getting the result. This is the ultra capacitor has been tested. That is the market based capacitor we have utilized. This is the basic arrangement. Okay, but for our cell, this is result what we have described here. Look at this. This cell has been fabricated for the P-based activated carbon and electrolyte material, which has been synthesized by mixing the PVDF as a polymer, TaBF4 as a P-based salt based electrolyte, and we have added here the SiO2 nano filler. So this is the device. How we can calculate the capacitance of the supercapacitor cell? There is a three techniques. First is your impedance, then CV, that is the cyclic voltammetry, and then the charge discharge. Look at this is your Nernst plot, and we can say this is the impedance plot. By using the impedance spectroscopic technique, we can calculate the capacitance. Look at this. Z dash versus Z double dash plot has been obtained here. And this is the very semicircle has been obtained. That particular portion has been shown for the your charge transfer characteristics. However, from this is we are getting the bulk resistance. So by using this particular equation, we get the capacitance. So look at this is that this particular work has been done by our laboratory. And we are getting the capacitance approximately 347.9 millifarad per centimeter square. And this is in the farad per gram. So this is from the impedance technique. You can also fit your work by the equivalent circuit and just compare your RB, that is the resistance, bulk resistance. Similarly, this is the cyclic voltammetry. Look at this current versus potential plot here. And based on this particular plot, the calculation, we are getting the scan with various scan rate, we are getting the capacitance. And look at this, for this particular electrolyte system and the cell, we are getting 2000 approximately good cyclic stability has been found. So number of cycle are 2000, and we are getting the overall the constant capacitance. By using the charge discharge technique, you can also use the work. Maybe you can find the capacitance, power density, and the current density as shown in this particular diagram. So overall, in the energy storage system, if I'm asking, by the comparison of the batteries, look at this, is the lead acid battery and the ultra capacitor. Okay, so data has been taken from the resources. Look at this, the charging time in the capacitor is very less. It's approximately 1 to 30 seconds. However, your battery is taking the time is 1 to 5 hours. The discharge time is 0 to 30 seconds. Perhaps it has been taken from 0.3 to 3 hours. Energy density has a value approximately 1 to 15. However, battery have a good energy density. Perhaps the power density in the supercapacitor is very high. So these are the various factors we can compare with the batteries. Okay, so this is the comparison between the battery and the supercapacitor. Okay, in the terms of the energy, power density, energy density, charge rate, and the charge life information. So this you can see the region plot. Now, so the thing is, why the hybridization of the energy storage device? Both have their own specific property, like in the battery as the supercapacitor. So why the hybrid source is required in the society? The thing is that first point, what we have to focus on, because of the low energy density of the traditional battery, the space of the work is what. Another thing is that reduce the battery life due to the frequent charging and the discharging, and also the reduction in the mailing range due to the acceleration, and require the power is the key factor between battery sizing and the resulting oversized battery backup. System should be able to good performance in the terms of the energy density as well as the power density. So capability during the acceleration and the braking phase, there is a need to do the hybridization of the electrical energy storage devices. So main thing is that the hybrid energy storage device have a two part, that is the main energy system, another is the rechargeable energy storage system. So in that particular part, supercapacitor plus battery, we can use that supercapacitor. Look at this, student. Here two type of the device we have to mix. For this purpose, we have to utilize both two type of the electrode material, that is the ferritic and the non-ferritic material we have to utilize for the supercapacitor. Okay, so supercapacitor is why? Because it increasing the rated capacity, as well as limiting the temperature rising inside the battery. It reduces the energy losses. Also, it increases the battery in the life, increasing the battery life cycle. So, hybridization of energy storage system is very much required nowadays. Battery is a high energy density, and energy density which is better suited to meet average load demand, and the supercapacitor or ultra capacitor is a high power density energy storage device. And you can see the battery plus capacitor, we have to utilize our effort in this particular scale. So in hybrid energy storage system, this is the effective solution of the whole type of the problems has been obtained from the battery and the supercapacitor. So hybridization of the topology can be result in increasing this risk. So basic idea of the hybrid electrical vehicle or hybrid energy storage system is to combine the supercapacitor and the batteries to achieve overall the performance, and this is because the compare to to the battery and the capacitor, super capacitor have a higher power density and the energy density. Okay, so we have to combine these things, these two types of the device. Okay, for voltage strategy of the two energy storage device in the designing of a battery as well as the super capacitor, we have to select the voltage strategy strongly. And depending on the characteristics of the battery and the ultra capacitors, voltage track off between the storage element. So DC-DC converter need to match. Okay. Also, effective utilization of the ultra capacitor stored the energy. Energy delivered in the battery is not a function of the voltage. So these are the various factors. Okay. Okay. So how much time still I have? Okay. I have. Hello, I'm audible.
Madam, 20 minutes.
Yeah. So you can see here, this is the energy flow in the vehicle, in a multi-energy system. And all of you who are in the automobile system, automobile field, you will get very, very clearly. This is the energy flow in the vehicle, in the multiple energy systems. So here, these are the battery and the capacitor. This is the DC-DC converter. And by this, driving the motors. So this is the natural condition. The accelerator or the uphill condition is here. You can see battery and that ultra capacitor, DC-DC converter is here, and this is the driving motor. So this is the basic thing. The question is that why and what exactly the need of electrical vehicle. The automobile in the use around the world causes the serious problem to the environment in the human life, like air pollution, global warming, and the rapid depletion of the earth petroleum resources. So what exactly the solution is? We have to replace it by the electrical vehicle, by the hybrid energy vehicle, and the fuel cell electrical vehicle. So for this purpose, what exactly the electrical vehicle is? Here, this is the chart where we can see the very, very clearly the system in the electrical vehicles has been shown here. These are the part in this particular form. And you can see the need is what? That is, we have to just connect these two type of the devices with each other. We have to find these are the various type of the electrical vehicle shown in this particular diagram. Look at this. Is the hybrid vehicle and the plug-in hybrid electrical vehicle, battery electrical vehicle, and you can see the conventional vehicle has been shown here, the fuel, engine, and all. This has been updated by the hybrid electrical vehicle, by the battery, fuel, motors, and the engine, and then after battery vehicle, it looks like this. So there is a need to just do some correction on it. So look at this. Basically, in electrical vehicle have a various part like power electronics, electrical motor, radiation, engines, fuel storage, the battery, charger, and all. So gradually decrease the fossil fuels as well as hike in oils prices. Also, it increases the number of vehicle on the road, leading the massive pollution in air and water. That is cleaner in the environment. So various laws of the implemented in the countries. So electrical dynamics and the models are available. Look at this here. And also designing the calculations and the sizing of the battery is a major part. You can use this particular points, and here the battery has been, we can calculate the age calculation by using this particular formula. This is the thing. These are various models of the electrical vehicle available in the market. You can see the batteries, range, and all. So our point, that is the hybrid energy storage device. Okay, supercapacitor plus battery, that's become supercapacitor. various type of the literature available in the sources. I have selected few for the that particular sharing information. People are trying to develop the electrode material for the hybrid energy storage devices. For this purpose, they have taken various type of the material. One of them is the CNO3 ultra-3. So for this purpose, they have taken the blend form of the polymer, that is the PBA and the PBB. These are two type of the polymer. It has been blended with each other. Then after having adding ammonia solution has been added. This is the process by which we get that particular form of the synthesis of the nanostructure CEO3. And for using this particular cell, like a graphene-based material, one is the graphene-based material, another is the CEO3 material. This is the hybrid storage devices, a device, and by this they get the good cyclic stability as well as good capacitance value. Another work which has been reflected in the mind, that is the Ni and the NiO nitrogen dropped based carbon hetero structure. For this purpose, they have taken various type of the techniques and they get good result and all. The main thing, what exactly the focus on that NiNiO based NaC pyrolysis process has been adopted method, and the energy density and the power density has been obtained very high, and also you can see the high cycle. So there is some space that we can try this particular material in the terms of the electrical vehicle. There is a space you can utilize this type of the material in the hybrid vehicle, and you will get that value. So the people are tried their work in the operation of the LED. However, the next point we have to focus, that is the carbon quantum dot. The carbon quantum dot is play major role and a very very new point that we have to add this in electrode material. And by adding this carbon quantum dot in your electrode material, it emerges a potential electrostatic nanomaterial and having something size 2 to 5 nm, and having good this can provide the good capacitance of that particular electric device. So this is the various type of the carbon quantum dot has been synthesized by using this technique. So they utilize the milk and dye it in 5 days. And by this heterothermal process, get the quantum dots, and that quantum dots have been utilized for the electrode materials. For this purpose, they get good capacitance value, and the comparative studies has been shown here, that is 1200 cycles, and these are the cycle numbers. The point of this, we can say the people are started for the hybrid energy storage devices, but not that much utilized in the electrical vehicle. If you can utilize this in electrical form, electrical vehicle way, you will get the good results and you will improve your electrical vehicle. Here, this is another form you can utilize the coin cell for the synthesis of this device. And these are the various type of the energy and the power density, basically based on the Bi2O3 based carbon quantum dot, and they have utilized, they get the result in the 8400. That is a huge amount of the power density. So these are the things. So thank you so much. Maybe that is completed from my side.